All right, good day, student. As you can see, what we have today is circle geometry. Three circumscribed circle, congruent circles with radius 5 cm. There is another small circle at the center. You are required to find the radius of this small circle, that is R1. So the first thing is to first notice here there is a center at the circle. The square circle touches the outer other circles. It's a big circles. It has tangent to them. It touches them at only one point. So you are required to find the radius of the of this small circle, square circle. So the first thing to do is to join the centers. If you join the centers of the circle, we can obtain a triangle. For example, if we join here to the center, this is a straight line. Join to the center, this is a straight line. You join this to the center and then join here. It form a triangle. The center here is O. So it form a triangle in this form when the centers are joined. So that here will be A, here will be O, and here will be B. So this is 5. Since it form a triangle, this side is equal to this side. And then we have what? The radius of this small circles is R1. Here will be equal to R1 plus 5, and here will be R1 plus 5. So this, the eyes you need. Here will be what? Since it is joined together, here is R, that is 5, and here is R, and that is 5. So joining A and B, we have what? 5 plus 5 is 10. So here will be what? 10. So are you seeing it? Once we have done that, we will now solve it. We will now find the how do we obtain the angle here? Since we know from here there are three intangents to this point, to the center of here, which means if we draw a straight line here, draw a straight line, there are three tangents that enter to the center of the small circle. So it will be like this. That is how it looks, the center, when they are joined. They give equal space. Since they are give equal space, which means the angle here will be divided into 3. That is 360 divided by 3. That give us 120 degree. So angle here is equal to 120 degree. Since the spaces are equal, and it's because the circles are equal, they have the same property. They are congruent circles. And then small circle is inscribing at the center, they will track the equal distance between them to the center of the small circle. That means the distance here is equal to here, is equal to here, the equal length of an arc. So with that knowledge, we know that the angle at the center will be divided by 3. So this gives us 120. From here we can use cosine rule. Cosine rule to find R1. Use cosine rule to find R1. So, which means in this case we can now use cosine rule. Then this means AB. So this means AB is 10. We can now use a cosine rule to solve it. We begin. This gives us 10 squared is equal to what? R1 plus 5 squared plus what? R1 plus 5 squared. Are you seeing it? So this means 100 is equals to what? 2 in bracket R1 plus 5 squared. This gives us 2 in bracket, square this one. If you squared that, we have done expansion of a quadratic expression. You square the first one, it gives us R1 squared. You square this one, it will give us what? 25 plus this time, this 5 times R1 times 2. This will give us 10 R1. So 100, are you seeing it? 100 is equals to open bracket, give us 2 R1 squared plus 50 plus what? 20 R1. So we proceed again, we collect light terms. 100 crossing to the other side, we have 2 R1 squared plus, bring this one here, 20 R1. Coming to this side, we give us 50 minus 100. This give us minus 50. Equals to what? 0. So, from here we proceed. Are you following? From here we proceed. So bringing this equation up, if we bring the equation up, we have 2R1 squared plus 20R1 minus 50 is equals to 0. So we can still simplify. Divide by 2. If we divide by 2, we have what? They give us R1 squared plus 10R1 minus 25 is equals to 0. So this form a quadratic equation in R. So how do you simplify it? Form equation in R. So from here we can use the general formula. We can use the general formula to solve it. So from here, using general formula, we have R1 is equals to minus 10 plus the square root of what? Square this one will give us 100. Because of minus here, we can now put plus in bracket 4 times 25. Are you seeing it? 4 times 25 divided by 2. So R1 is equals to minus 10 plus or minus, you know, this one is, we give us what? The square root of 200. Is it not 200 divided by 2? So are you seeing it? So R1 is equals to what? This gives us minus 10 plus or minus, you can use, you can leave the answer in solid equation. From here we have what? 10, the square root of 2 divided by 2. So R1 is equals to what? 10 is common. You can bring it out, you can rearrange this equation. If you rearrange this equation, okay, leave it for now. Mind you, you can ignore negative. You can ignore the negative because we are talking of length. So you can ignore the negative. So from here we have what? And rearrange the equation, the expression, we have 10 root 2 minus 10. Are you seeing it? Divided by 2. So from here, we proceed. You can bring 10 out. If you bring 10 out, we have root 2 minus 1 divided by 2. Are you seeing it? Bring 10 out. We have this 10 in bracket root 2 minus 1 divided by 2. So 2 can divide, 10 can divide by 2. We have R1 equals to what? 5 in bracket root 2 minus 1. So this is it, unit. You have to put the unit. So this is what you are required to solve. R1 is equal to 5 in bracket root 2 minus 1. So do you have any question? So there is no question. We proceed in the next section. Endeavor to subscribe to my channel for more videos for your view. See you in the next section. Bye for now.